I'm Aaron Gold, and today is kind of a bittersweet day because we are driving the 2015 Mitsubishi Lancer Evolution Final Edition. This is the end of the road for one of my favorite performance cars. This is basically a road-going rally car, 300 horsepower, all-wheel drive, one of the most thrilling cars I've ever driven. But if I'm honest, and occasionally that happens, there is a little part of me that kind of thinks that maybe it's time for the Evo to go. And that part of me is me. Now, the Evo may have been a great car in its day, but it is hopelessly outdated. How can you say this thing is outdated? I mean, you've seen the spec sheet. Look at this. You have a 2-liter, 4-cylinder engine, turbocharged and intercooled to produce 303 horsepower. That's up from 291 in the normal Evo. Now, normally the Evo comes in two models, the MR and the GSR, and the final edition is really the best of both worlds. You get the I-back springs and the Bilstein shocks, or maybe that's the Bilstein shocks. Now, Bilstein was a guy I went to school with. Anyway, you also get the two-piece lightweight brake rotors that are all off the Lancer MR, but you get the manual transmission that comes in the Lancer GSR. And it's tied to this incredible high-tech all-wheel drive system, which is really what Mitsubishi does best. Yeah, that was all really impressive 10 years ago when the Evo came out, okay? But nowadays, you can get a Hyundai Sonata that's got a 2-liter turbo engine that produces 250 horsepower and gets much better gas mileage. Today, not so impressive. Don't turn around. Okay, so maybe the numbers aren't all that impressive, but the way this thing goes down the road is just unreal. I mean, the way it develops power, when you hit 3,000 RPM and that turbo kicks in, it's like opening Pandora's box. Boom, the power comes on hard and heavy and it just never lets off. And the grip just absolutely defies belief. Now, Mitsubishi used to run a special performance school in which they taught you how to drive an Evo. And they basically taught you to drive it badly. You had to ham fist the thing into the corners, and that would fool the all-wheel drive system into sending the power to the outside rear wheel. So the car would just explode out of the corners. Now, I don't have the skills or the gentlemanly bits to drive it like that, but I just enjoy flying into the corners, getting on the gas, and just blasting right out. I mean, it's so hard to find the limits of grip, and when you do hit those limits of grip, you can feel the all-wheel drive system kind of scrabbling to find out where there is some grip to be had. The car might skip a little bit, but then it just digs in and it goes. It's so fast, it's so thrilling, I absolutely love it. It's like driving a racing car legally on public roads. Listen, there's a reason the people who own racing cars don't drive them every day, and that's because they would be absolutely miserable. I mean, this thing is so noisy, we can barely hear ourselves think. It rides like an ox cart. It's got this cheap plastic interior. The most interesting piece of trim is the sticker that tells you you're going to go through tires like crazy. I mean, come on. This is good fun on a curvy road like this, but people still have to drive to work. And when you're just commuting, this isn't a form of transportation. It's a mobile form of corporal punishment. Now, I haven't even talked about the running costs, because in my week with this car, it gets about 15 miles per gallon around town, maybe 21 miles per gallon on the highway, and if you drive it the way it wants to be driven, which is the way we're driving it right now, it gets about 10 miles per gallon, which is worse than the Viper that we tested a few months ago. It goes through tires every 10 minutes. It's going to need a clutch every half hour. I mean, the bottom line is you have to be a masochist to want to buy one of these. My goodness, when did I become such a curmudgeon? Listen, if you want a Toyota Camry, buy yourself a Toyota Camry. This car is not supposed to be comfortable. It's not meant to coddle you. This is what happens when you say to your engineers, make it go, turn, and stop as fast as humanly possible, and nothing else matters. This is engineering unbridled. This is the epitome of the phrase, be careful what you wish for. And that's what sets the Evolution apart from every other car out there. No other car is so devoted to speed at the expense of everything else. That's why I love it. Where'd my mustache go? Now, I know that a part of me is really lamenting the loss of the Lancer Evolution, but it's not as if we're being left with a complete vacuum. Okay, first of all, the Evo's arch enemy, the Subaru WRX STI, that's still on sale. Very fast, very thrilling, doesn't quite have the hard edge of the Evo, and if you ask me, or at least this part of me, that's one of the advantages. And there's the Volkswagen Golf R, more expensive than the Evo, but a lot more refined, and every bit as quick and every bit as thrilling to drive. Now, if you can't afford the price tag of these vehicles, check out Subaru's WRX. Not quite as powerful, not quite as quick, but still a lot of fun to drive. And if you insist on blowing way too much money on a car that's gonna kick the daylights out of you every time you drive it, well then why don't you just do it right and get yourself a Nissan GT-R. I'm sorry, Evo hater me is completely missing the point. Yes, there are plenty of all-wheel drive turbocharged cars that are a lot of fun to drive. But see, the thing is, everything that's wrong with the Evo is exactly what is right with the Evo. It's that this car is so unrefined and so raw that makes it really great. There is just nothing else like it. And I, for one, really appreciate the fact that we have this opportunity. Mitsubishi, thank you very much for unleashing this car on the American public. I also want to thank you for watching. I'm Aaron Gold.
And I'm also Aaron Gold,
and we'll see you next time. Aaron is so happy because he gets to drive an Evo. If I had a Golf R, I would get in it and leave. Oh, do 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 do. All right. Okay.
I think the seatbelt's on the mic.
Oh, okay. Are we good now?
Yeah. Hurry up.
Hold on. Let me put the mic on the seatbelt. No, we got time. We're professionals. We do this all the time. Okay, you ready?
Rolling.
Listen, there's a reason that...